At the end of last exercise, we finished making the events page using repeaters and masters. For those who want to do all the exercises, the next step was to make the location page. I'm not going to show you all the steps of making the page, but here's a preview of the final version, what it should look like when you're finished, while using masters and repeaters. In this exercise video, we're going to focus on the buy tickets page. The buy tickets page looks like this. First, I noticed the menu on the left side here is the same as on the location page, so I'm going to convert it to a master to be able to reuse it. The top of the page has the same structure, so I'm going to select the header, the background image, and the menu on the left, and just copy-paste them onto the buy page. I check the alignment is right by sending the whole group to the back and bringing it back to the front. And now I'm just going to add all of the text content using different types of widgets. I'll just speed this up a little. On the site, this section of the page allows you to preview the total price for a certain number of tickets of different types. So in order to be able to simulate this, I'm going to use actual text fields for the numbers and buttons for the plus and minus buttons. But for now, I'm just going to add all of the text. The important part is that although this looks like a list, I'm not going to use a repeater here. I'll also spend some extra time to add the right text in the different fields. I'll use the secondary button widget for my plus and minus buttons. And I'll use a text field for the number because I want to be able to just type a number of tickets inside. And now I'm spending some extra time to align everything properly using the Align and Distribute buttons. Now that I have aligned the elements on each line, I want to distribute all of the lines vertically. In order to do that, you need to group all the elements of every line so that the result will distribute every line and not all the individual items within the lines. So now that every line is grouped, I can select all of the groups and distribute them vertically. After I position the gray rectangle as a background here, I'll just send it to the back so that it's not hiding the other elements I need to prototype. And I'm reaching the bottom of the page, so now I just have to add the masters that I created earlier. I'm done, so now I just have to remove the background images I used as a reference, and in the next exercise we're going to link all those four pages together.